Welcome back. Happy Monday morning to you. How was your weekend? Let's talk about your weekend for a little bit. My weekend went exceedingly well. I have no complaints. I sat here and had some moments of peace and quiet. Just me and Mr. Bub chilling out, watching a little YouTube, hanging out, having a great time. What did you do this weekend? Did you have fun? Did you get a little bit of that R&R that you needed? Kind of getting back to you? I hope so. Because something tells me this week, you're going to need that. You're going to need that calm center. You're going to need a little bit of discernment as well. But then again, you're always going to need that. But it's going to be more so this week than in previous weeks. So hold on to that. A little bit of news. Highfiving.com is back. The link has always been in the description down below. You can come find me there. It has been completely relaunched. So everything about the site is new. And I hope you'll join me either there or speakyourmindhere.com, over at pill.net, perhaps on Twitter. But just in case I say something that the Twitter Gestapo doesn't like, perhaps you'll join me there. When Hiven Play is relaunched, I fully intend to put this channel onto that. And the reason being is because, in case I say something the YouTube Gestapo doesn't like, and they shut this channel down, know that I won't be too heartbroken because I haven't monetized it, and I never will. You will be able to find me there. So, come over onto one of my free speech hangouts. Join me. Hang out for a moment. Let's talk. Let's hang out. It's not going to be just tarot or spirituality that I talk about. We can talk about anything. Everyday carry is one of my favorite subjects. So we can talk about, you know, hey, what kind of pocket knife do you like? You prefer Leatherman or Swiss Army knife? Me, I like both. Not necessarily one over the other. What kind of tea do you like? Did you read any books? Watch any good movies lately? That sort of thing. We can hang out and just chat like normal human beings, or maybe even talk role-playing games. I tend to love those. In fact, for like $5, I just bought a ton of, you know, PDF books. So, who knows? Maybe we can go on Discord and start up a role-playing group and play a little bit. Whatever you like. Maybe you have one and you'd like me to join. I'm open. Anyway, let's get right into this for Monday. We need to know who our guide is for this particular Monday morning. Oh, wow. Okay, well, we've never had this one before. Loki. There's a whole lot going around about Loki in social media these days. Who knows, maybe Loki can help this channel get a little more clout, huh? Oh boy. Loki, Loki, Loki. I knew sooner or later he would come up. It's kind of a numbers game, really. Okay. So, fin, fur, scale, skin, flight, fight, song, sin, all are available to me. I shift my shape and your mind. I trick my way into your play. So, with Loki, he is telling us to develop our gifts of oration and clear speech. Play more often. Laughter is a God's given gift. There may be someone in your life that isn't what they seem. Try a more lighthearted approach. I'm going to take that as beware there may be a little trickery around. Don't take everything at face value. Definitely don't take everything at face value. I can't emphasize that one enough. Okay, so our spirit animal. We got the panther spirit again. So we're reclaiming our power. And so far by not taking everything at face value, we're actually reclaiming our power a bit. Let me give you an example of that one. Every one of us puts on sort of an image. As we get to know each other, we kind of let that image kind of just move aside a little bit. Now, the more we get to know each other, the closer we get to somebody, oftentimes they get to really know who we are. They get past the image, they get past all the little likes and dislikes, and then finally they just come to the core of everything. When we put on that image, when someone else puts on that image, that's the power that they're exerting. Here's who I claim to be. Meanwhile, you're kind of like, you know, you're using your discernment and trying to kind of cut through all that to find out what this person's actually about. Everyone has an agenda. Everyone has an agenda. Everyone has that thing that they're putting out there. I'm no exception. Okay, so the question is, will that person tell you what the agenda is? My agenda is to this morning get this thing to you. That way you can successfully navigate your Monday. That's it. Again, I'm not asking for money or anything like that. I'm doing this because it's fun. It's something I love to do. I just can't do it every morning, so now I'm doing it, you know, 5 days a week instead of six, you know, kind of giving myself a little bit of a break there. Yeah, it's all good. So, for our past, the sun, for our present, the four of coins, and for our future, a nine of coins. Now, for our past, that sun is everything. If you look at it, what was that line from Spider-Man 2? The power of the sun in the palm of my hands. So we're kind of drawing on that, I think. The sun's energy is something that that gives us quite a bit. It'll give you all kinds of great things. At the same time, it can also be very destructive, so you have to handle it very carefully. But there are solutions. There was hope, that clear-sightedness. This is where that self-awareness really comes into play. And you need that. So that self-awareness. Now, right now, you might be kind of sitting tight on some money. Or you might be holding on to, I definitely see it as holding on to something. Look how tightly wound all that is. As a matter of fact, this symbol, this is actually a symbol, believe it or not. A pile of sticks bound together. It's called a fasci. So you got that fasci going on there. Feeling a little fascist, are you? Kidding. It's a play on words. This is where your frugality has been so far. And of course, being careful how you wield your own power, your own self-awareness, that's admirable. And I think it's going to bring you a little bit of success here. So, nothing terrible right now. You're just being careful, and this is showing you that you're actually on the right path. Being a little, nothing wrong with being a little careful with the money and kind of, you know, not being quick to spend it or spending it wisely. So, we have Hierath again, Child of the Cosmos. Oh, I really haven't seen that one. I don't think that one we've seen before. And of course, Forge Don't Follow. Boy, that one pops up a lot, doesn't it? It's like our guides really believe, or at least mine do, in that Forge Don't Follow. Get out of this, get out of following people. You know, and the thing is, even though the coins do represent earthly things, this could be something like a job. This could be something like just some material possession. You may be holding on to something. There's nothing wrong with that as long as it's bringing you joy. As long as you're preserving something that is helping you and not harming you. But right now, there is this one longing for home, homesick for the stars. I can tell you one thing, I know that feeling, definitely. But if you're feeling that bit of homesickness, you're resonating with that yearning from home, just don't really know where it is, this is where you're being told, hey, you chose to be here. This is your home. You chose to be here, so be here right now. There's nothing wrong with that. And just remember, right now, just remember that the intelligence you need is in every cell in your body, and that's where this comes into play. Right now, you want to go back to something. You want to go back to something comfortable. I think in one of the readings previously, from maybe like a few days ago, if I recall this correctly, you were being told that once you step out of the comfort of something and take that chance on something greater, the other thing is dead and gone forever. And you're going to want to go back to that. Now is not the time for that. Let that be in the past. Seriously. Right now you may be approaching things from a beginner mindset. You may be a little frustrated that you don't know everything. That is perfectly normal. Just remember, right now, there are times where you don't have to have all the answers. But this is one of those times today when you already have the answers you need. And that's why Forge Don't Follow comes up, because you need to be the leader you want or you need. Okay? It's all on you today. And you have to take a very grounded approach to things. So for the cap on this thing, let's see what secrets we may have. Unsus Manas Righto. Okay. But today's one of those days when you need to be very clear about what you're communicating. That's what Ansu's is. Ansu's is that breath or communication, voice. There was a lot of, in Norse culture, there was a lot of emphasis placed around Ansu's. So today is one of those days where you're going to need to communicate very clearly. Also think clearly. And this is where Unsus is one of those really great runes, because it does point at that child of the cosmos again, right here. Because basically what it says is, you already have the knowledge you need. But this, with Unsus, you've inherited positive and negative aspects from your ancestors. So it's very important to know which ones are going to serve you and which ones are not. Remember, if what you're using is not serving you, if it's not helping you, then it's time to let it go. That's where Manas comes in, because Manas is telling you, develop yourself in all the ways you can. So again, with this development, you need that personal growth. So pointing at that Nine of Coins here. And then Raidho is one of the ones that lets you know, focus on the now rather than the burdens of the past or the unrealized future. Work with the rhythms of life, not against them. So your journey is just as important as your destination. So the biggest message I'm getting from all of this right now that we've got all the cards out and we've dealt with the minutia, number one, things are not always going to be as they seem. So remember, employ a little clear and logical thinking, because you're going to run into situations where someone or something is going to seek to take power away from you. You have to be able to say no, stop. You're going to have to think logically and clearly. You have to communicate very openly, very clearly, and you know, make sure you get your thoughts straight. The great thing about it is, you're actually kind of on the right path. If you've been taking the advice of the previous readings, you're pretty well okay. Right now, you really do want to go back. Oh my goodness, I remember when I could do this, that, and the third. Well, was it really serving you? The answer is no, no. And right now, you don't think you have the answers, but you do. You're going to have to take the lead. You're going to have to take charge. And that's what helps you move forward. This is pointing you toward the joys in life. And your joys are your signposts. And that's where Raidho points you out. But you must remember, don't let someone else trick you into doing something they want you to do. Okay? Now is the time. Just hold your course. Hold the line. Think and speak clearly. Become the leader that you want, or that you wish you had. Let that be a sense of personal development. You are going to grow. And you're going to turn out okay. And so far, I think, you know, just from what I'm getting out of this, I mean, even Unsus can point toward leadership and power of words and vision. That's something else. That's another bit of meaning there. And Raidho is definitely one of those that points to dance of life, you know. Or I said this weekend, dance around a little bit. Find yourself alone, just kind of dance around a little bit. Did it help? Because that's coming up again. But this can also mean a little bit of travel. Might be a good time to do that. Anyway, that's all I have for you today. I hope this resonated with you, and I hope Hope it made sense. Remember, I haven't really had my first full cup of tea yet. Thank you for being here. Thank you for sharing this moment with me in the morning. Remember, you watching this right now, I love you. I hope you have a great Monday. I hope you have a great week. I'll be back tomorrow. We'll do this again. Sound good? Alright. So as always, this is your boy Raven saying, as always, shine on.